Howdy guys, I'm back with more Final Fantasy IX. Last time I left you off here in the Gate to Space in Memoria. Very, very close to the end of the game. In fact, I think somewhere around here if you get here in 12 hours, Steiner gets a really ridiculous weapon, I believe. There's nothing. Is this it? Is there nothing else? This is space. Space? Your journey is not over. Do not fear. Step forward and you will be closer to the truth. Go, Zidane. That's easy for you to say. Oh well. Just believe. We're just walking through space right now. That is a song from the musical Hair. Am I walking around? Can I control them? Or I think I'm walking around. I can't. I'm gonna push buttons and assume I'm doing something. I'm gonna go push forward. I feel like I'm doing something. You have entered a new realm. There are no more worlds. There is no more space. Follow your memory, your original memory, and march forth. Garland, what exactly is our memory? Why can't I remember other people's experiences and events that happened before my time? Garland, please tell me. Do not limit memory to just one individual's experiences from birth. That is only the surface. Every life born into this world, whether natural or artificial, requires a parent. And that parent also requires a parent. Life is connected one to another. Man, this is like some collective, collective consciousness type stuff or something. This is cool. This is a flying through space talking about some deep stuff. I feel like I need to put a Pink Floyd album on or something. Okay. If you trace the root of all life, there exists one source. The same can be said for memory. All life constitutes an intelligence that holds memory beyond experience. Memory is not isolated within individuals. It is an accumulation of generations of memories that continues to evolve. You can say that memory and evolution go hand in hand. But most life forms do not understand the true nature of memories, which explains why most memories never cross paths. Whoa, this is deep. So what am I going to find by tracing back our roots? A presence that presides over all life and memories. The crystal. Crystal? You are on your own now. Zidane, take care of Kuja. And protect the crystal. Farewell. Garland, wait! Garland! So did all life come from a crystal then? Even if I were created to serve one purpose alone, I do not regret being born to this world. Garland really wasn't too much different than the vessels when you think about it. Is this the crystal that Garland was talking about? Because, I mean, Garland just had one purpose to see over the fate of Terra. I mean, he was basically two notches above a vessel that just, you know, sat there like a zombie. You know, even though Garland was a bad guy here at the end, I can't help but almost feel bad for him. I really like this twisted Final Fantasy tune here. It's time for us to find out the truth. Alright, truth time, guys. Y'all ready for some truth? Hashtag okay, no, I'm joking. I'm sorry. Alright. I love this music, though. It's tripping me out. Ooh. Yeah, there's definitely crystals floating around. A crystal road. storm. And I love this music. This game has some fan. I really didn't know how good the music in this game was. I definitely didn't appreciate it. You know, the very first time I played with it, or played with it, listen to me, played it, but now it's like, I'm really appreciating it. Alright, I think there's an option for me to teleport here, so I'm thinking maybe this is point of no return up ahead. I know the ending's gotta be coming pretty soon, so let me go make a, like, fresh couple of saves here, just because I like to have some right before the end in case I ever want to go back and try to achieve other things. I'd probably just make a new playthrough if that was the case, though, because I missed so much. Alright, in we go. Alright, is this the end? Exclamation mark times three! Here, I should probably turn that off. There we go. Kuja! Nice of you to come! I'm surprised you beat the four chaoses that I created from the crystal's memory. But you're too late. Take a good look. Isn't it beautiful? It's the original crystal. This is where it all began. The birthplace of all things. Once I destroy it, everything will be gone. Gaia, Terra, the universe, everything. Your lives and memories too, of course. So, man, why would the center of the universe that connects everything be so vulnerable? It seems like the powers that be would make sure that thing's under lock and key, but who am I to judge? Shut up! The only thing that's gonna be gone is you! I'll take you out right now! Humph, you honestly think you can beat me? Even if you do, Gaia's already doomed. Its assimilation by Terra has begun, and the Ifa tree will indicate or incite a cataclysmic destruction of Gaia. It's all over for you and your friends. See, I win either way. It doesn't matter. Even if Gaia is assimilated, the planet will remain and we'll start over and make a new home. Kuja, you're nothing but a coward. If you're gonna die, leave us out of it. Why should the world exist without me? That wouldn't be fair. So this is what you call, narcissistic personality disorder, I believe, right? If I die, we all die. Zidane, you will be my first sacrifice. Oh, here it is. This is gonna be juicy, juicy, juicy. Nothing like putting down a narcissist. And he knows it too. Like, Kuja, I think Kuja is really well written. He's like, I personally think he's an interesting character. Like, his dialogue and stuff. You know, maybe not all the characters are perfect, but Kuja, you know, Final Fantasy X, they can write a good bad guy, usually. Alright, Death Guys is casting Meteor on my whole face. Let's see how that does to me. Let's see. Alright, Aiko just ripped there, so let's bring her up. Alright, and then let's, I don't want to cheese this guy with Dragon's Crest. I'm just gonna jump on him. I don't really know if it's cheese anymore at this point, because, Aiko's Holy does 9,999 damage anyway. Alright, so let's see, let's throw some Cura, or let's go ahead and do a Cura. Well, no, let's do a Cura. Let's conserve our mana here. And let's start pelting this guy with some damage while Zidane steals. I feel like Zidane never get. He's entranced right now. And he doesn't even. I gotta steal from him. I'm sorry, I never get to see how cool you are, Zidane. You're too busy having to steal all the time. Sorry, Zidane. I'm sorry. Alright, I don't know. To hell with it. I'm gonna cast Dragon's Crest. Whatever. I killed lots and ooh, a black belt. Oh, that's not all that good. Never mind. I don't know. I'm oohing over here. Alright. Gonna keep stealing from Death Guys. Don't know if he has anything good at this point or if it even matters. I'm not even sure if it matters. I think I'm at the last, if not second to last. Maybe not. Maybe there's more to go. I played through the game once, and I do remember, like, there's a final boss, and then there's, like, another boss that doesn't seem like... It seems kind of like it came out of nowhere. That's how I remember it, anyway. Maybe I'm completely wrong, because when I played Final Fantasy IX before, I got through the first three discs, and then I took, like, a multi-month break between disc 3 and disc 4, and then came back and didn't really remember what was going on in the first place, so... My first playthrough of this game was a disaster. Which, funny enough, my second playthrough hasn't been much better. It's still been a disaster, but hey, you know, at least I kept up with it and didn't abandon it for a few months. And, you know, yeah, I might have missed a lot of treasures and side stuff, but, you know, I completely disregarded the Chocobo stuff, and, like, all the side stuff in my first playthrough, so I consider myself doing pretty good, even given all the things that I've missed. How did they beat Death Guys? Do you really think you can beat me? What the heck? Alright, Kuja. What's next? What else you got for me, man? What else you got for me? I guess I could have walked away, but I went forward. I can't believe you beat Death Guys! Well, my time is almost up. Time to die, everyone! Oh man, I really should have gone back and used it. Can I go back? Man... I really should have gone back. I didn't realize that I mean, I should have realized. It's like, Kuja's right there. What are you going to do? Walk forward or backward or forward, apparently. Alright, Kuja, let's do it. You and me, man. Alright, well, is there any real point in me stealing from him? He's going to cast Reflect, which is funny because I have Reflect on, so we're just going to Reflectception over here. Alright, so I'm gonna go kind of easy on... Well, not super easy on him, but I think I want to hear his theme for sure. Because it's pretty cool so far. Alright, yeah, I'm gonna kind of take it maybe a little bit easy on him. Because I want to enjoy his theme a little bit. Yeah, Kuja thinks he's been toying with me. I've been toying with him the whole time. Sorry, Kuja, you ain't got nothing on me, I think. I don't think he has anything on me anyway. Yeah, even his, like, strong attacks are just, like, a little... Well, hold on, I better calm my Jelly Roll real fast because he's using Flare Star. Ooh, shiny. Extremely shiny. Man, I see why they have those seizure warnings on games. That hurt my face to look at. Or not my face, my eyes. Derp. Alright, I probably just might have Aiko cast, like, Cura, or kind of like a mid-range heal every turn, so that she does... Because her health is pretty low. Alright, a Stolen Aether, which is nothing to write home about. He just keeps spamming us with Holy, too. Like, it's like, I think he counterattacks with Holy or something, because he uses it a lot. Oh, Amaranth has healed him again. Flare Star again. Alright, so let's no mercy him. Let's not ever attack ever again, basically. Oh, man. That's just too many colors for me. That seriously hurts my eyes. That's too much. Good thing that Freya was in the air and missed all that. Alright, Freya. Alright, we got Cura coming out. I think I'm just gonna keep jumping. That seems probably to be the safest thing against Kuja. Like, Freya in general, like, even if you weren't, like, 40 levels higher than you're supposed to be at this point, I think Freya in general is a good choice for this fight because this guy has a lot of, ruins your whole face abilities and she can just avoid it by being in the air. And then, yeah, reflect, it's like, this can be kind of a pain for Vivi if you don't have the right setup on him, right? I don't know, I think this is a good group. It's like the side characters. It's not, you know, the white mage, the black mage, the warrior, the thief. It's like the monk, the dragoon, the summoner. It's like the rejects. Like when you play these games, it's like no one wants to group with a dragoon, man. I like my reject group though. This is a good group. But I don't know. I kind of like the whole traditional warrior, rogue, thief type, white mage type, black mage type too. It's kind of fun too. It seems more appropriate to finish the game with Steiner, Garnet, Vivi, because it's like who you start out with, right? But I just like these guys so much. I don't know. I don't like this spell. I feel like I need to start going more all out on this guy. I don't know if I should keep trying to. Ooh, that's bad. He's hit it twice in a row. Good thing I have. Amaranth might die. Good thing I have regen on everybody. My gosh, the animation is so long that everyone healed up a little bit. Alright, I think I'm gonna have to. Kiraga maybe on Aiko. I have her casting Kira. That may not be enough anymore. Amaranth's tranced now. He looks like such a hot mess when he's tranced, dude. He's like naked, fisty man. You're gonna cast Kiraga on yourself, dude, really? Oh, he cast it. Oh. You're so funny. Okay. Man, by the time, like, this auto regen is so busted, by the time Aiko's cure goes off, like, no one needs it, basically. Couldn't steal anything. Of course you couldn't, Zidane. Of course you couldn't. I don't know if. No, I'm gonna keep the heals up, but Zidane's gonna have to do some damage at some point, I think, in order for me to beat Kuja, but I keep trying to steal from him. Alright, I'm gonna turn the speed boost on, because this is kind of just the same thing over and over at this point, so I'm not really gonna change up my tactics anymore. I'm feeling pretty good about the fight in general, so I'm just gonna keep doing the same thing, and hopefully I don't die in the face. Uh-oh. Ooh, that's bad. Okay, I need to slow down, I think. He got me with two flare stars at once. And see, I'm trying to go easy on him. Because Zidane, trying to steal for some reason on the last fight. Well, I don't know if this is the last fight. I think there's another one, but alright, speeding it up again. And, let's have him bring Aiko up. And then someday they'll use their items, and he can chakra, jump, steal, Kiraga. Oh, Amaranth died again. Flare. Wow, this guy can get you in a nasty combo, and you just can't do anything about it. It's kind of a pain in the butt. Kiraga. Alright, trance. Please, for the love of... I want to see what this guy has now at this point for me to keep missing the steal, so... Of course, I'm probably not going to see it if I... Oh, Aiko's tranced. Nice. So Kiraga and Holy have some damage going out, finally. Alright, so please... Oh, gosh. Can you please steal from a man? Like, I want to know what you have for me to keep being so unsuccessful with all these steals. Couldn't steal anything. Oh, my gosh. Would you please... Please steal, please. Oh, shoot, I'm sorry, guys. But I'm not gonna die alone. You're all coming with me. Uh-oh, he's using Ultima again. Sorry, I thought he would have had a lot more health than that, guys. I didn't know he was gonna dialogue at me. I thought this was gonna be a lot longer. Everyone's oh, jeez. Good thing I have Reflect. That reflects back, right? No, I saw him flying off the edge there. Ay. Kuja. What happened to the crystal? Where is this? You stand before the final dimension, and I am the darkness of eternity. Who are you? All life bears death from birth. Life fears death, but lives only to die. It starts with anxiety. Anxiety becomes fear. Fear leads to anger. Anger leads to hate. Hate leads to suffering. The only cure for this fear is total destruction. Kuja was a victim of his own fear. He concluded he could only save himself by destroying the origin of all things, the crystal. What the heck are you talking about? Why are you telling me all this? Now, the theory is undeniable. Kuja's action proves it. All things live to perish. At last, life has uncovered this truth. Now it is time to end this world.
Wow, that's depressing. So this thing is basically just saying the only point in living is to die, and I'm gonna have to disagree with you there, bud.
What do you mean by that?
I exist for one purpose. To return everything back to the zero world, where there is no life and no crystal to give life. In a world of nothing, fear does not exist. This is the world that all life desires.
Who in the hell do you think you are? You're not ending anything. Never, not as long as we have the will to live.
Foolish creature. Your fears have already deluded you. One day you will choose destruction over existence, just as Kuja did. When he sought to destroy the crystal, the purpose of life ended. Now come, enter the zero world that you desire.
No! We'll destroy you and prove you wrong, and through our memories, future generations will see that we can overcome any fear.
We can't give up now. We have to fight together. Even if we lose, it doesn't matter. Our memories will live on inside others. So even if we are born to die, I'm not afraid.
I'm gonna live!
Powerful worlds a day. Oh, gee, how nice. It lets me form my party here with one health. Grand.
Come back after you kill bad guy. I prepare a big meal for everyone.
Whoa. This is crazy.
Though I am unworthy, accept my powers.
Take my power. Take my power.
I'm sorry I couldn't do anything. Good luck.
Wow, way to make me feel bad. Sorry, Vivi. Your magic sucked. No, I'm just kidding. Vivi, you're alright. Sorry I couldn't bring you, little buddy.
Please accept my powers.
Cool.
Man, here it is, the Hill of Despair. I think we're ready for the final fight here. We've come too far to lose now. Let's just wrap this up and go home. All of us.
Okay, so I think I kind of was right about what I thought, that there just seemed like there was a random battle after Kuja, and this is it. This last boss seems like he just came out of nowhere, but I don't know if there's something I'm just not understanding or not getting, or if there's something I just haven't put together in my little potato head here. But I just, like, I don't know what I'm doing here, basically. I mean, this guy just came out of nowhere and he's like, I'm gonna destroy everything, okay? And it's like, no, why? So, yeah, I feel like there's Necron. Alright, well, I don't think there's... I stole an elixir. I don't really think there's any point in, stealing from him, but for old time's sake, why don't I do it? Just for old... Okay, blue shockwave. Alright, so that reduced Amaranth to 1 health, so... Aiko's gotta permanently be on healing duty, I think. Had her cast Holy, and that's probably not a grand idea. Well, I don't know, Amaranth's actually doing okay in the health department because of regen, but I'll have them throw a chakra on himself just in case something freaky happens, because, you know, strong and overleveled as I am, you know, couldn't steal anything, we're doing this again. You know, strong as I was, I still died a few times to, Kuja, but you know, you have to think I'm basically doing this with three people because the Dane can't steal anything or do anything the whole fight. I keep trying to get him to steal and he just stands there stealing never. I might have taken them off now, actually, now that I think about it, but I had like all the thief stuff that's supposed to increase his chance of stealing things, and oh boy, this is like Supernova from Final Fantasy VII. Super big, long, planet destroying magic summon here with lots of lights and colors and explosions. And how the heck does anyone live through this? I don't know. Like, let me just summon. Okay, Amaranth died. Alright, so that casts like death on people. Oh, and petrify on poor little Aiko. Let's go ahead and get that. I think Freya's berserked. That sucks, because I don't have, I guess I should have blocked all status ailments before doing this place. Alright, so let's do a full life on Amaranth. And, I don't know, should I keep trying to steal from this knucklehead? I mean, there's not really a point. And is Okay, alright. No, I was like, what now? Are we all dead? Alright, let's see. Alright, here we go. This cures Berserk. Let's get Berserk off Freya there. Feed her the chocobo food to get her to calm down. Alright, and... Alright, here we go. There's the full life. Boy, yeah, I don't know what it is. I keep trying to steal, even though this is the end of the game and there's no way he has anything I need, but something in me is like, I gotta steal. How come... Did full life not go off? He should... I don't understand what happened there. Did I... Screw it. Here, I'm gonna throw an elixir on Zidane, whatever. Nope. I'm not really sure why full life... What? Oh. Okay, it's missing, huh? Okay, well, I'm not really sure about that. Alright, well, can't... Here, throw a phoenix down on you. Can I miss that? Stolen elixir. Alright, this guy just has elixir, so I'm just gonna Dragon's Crest this knucklehead. Whatever, I'm done with this. I'm so donezies now. This guy's got... is kind of a beast, too. He's got, he gets, like, multiple ability, or gets to do multiple things a turn, it seems, which I guess it's fair. How is this... Am I daft? Is there something I'm not understanding about why Amaranth can't come back to life? Like, why the Phoenix Downs and stuff are missing? Like, is he just dead forever or something? Phoenix work? I'm not sure what's going on with that. That's new to me. So I'm just gonna pelt this guy with my hardest hitting things then, since it's gonna be ridiculous. And Amaranth can just sit there and eat dirt. Alright, that did pretty good damage. I'm gonna keep doing Thievery and Dragon's Crest, and I don't really know what I'm gonna do with Aiko. She can try to keep people alive, maybe, I don't really know. Yeah, this guy is definitely annoying as hell. Alright, Rebirth Flame, let's see, will that work? Doesn't hurt to try, right? Well, doesn't hurt me, it hurts him, hoo-hoo! Nope. Alright, so Amaranth's dead for the rest of the game, basically. He can't come back, he's gone forever. Sorry, Amaranth, I tried. I'm gonna just cast Holy now. Apparently Phoenix down in full life doesn't work, so I don't know. You're just gonna have to sit down there and eat dirt, buddy. Good luck to you. Alright, Thievery. Dragon's Crest. I kind of want to speed this up, but I'm afraid of missing dialogue like I did last time, because I did. Oh, why defy? Yep, see, of course, as soon as I speed it up, why defy your fate? What now? What happened? Is the will to live that powerful? This is not the end. I am eternal. As long as there is life and death. I'm scared. Ooh. All the mist is clearing out again. The roots are flying. Oh my gosh, this looks so freaky. What are the roots doing? Are you all right? Yeah, but look at what's happening. So what Kuja said was true. The Ifa tree is beginning its violent reaction. What's gonna happen? I don't know, but it doesn't look good. Cutscene time? No? I doubt anyone could have survived that explosion.
No! Captain.
They are still alive. What? Where are they? Over there. The Hildegard is probably closer. You, the tall one. Sir, Hagen, Pluto Knight 8, ma'am. I didn't ask for your name. Contact the Hildegard right away. Yes, sir, ma'am, sir.
Pluto Knights are still useless as ever.
Please be alive. Sire, we're receiving a transmission from the Red Rose. Punch it up on the main line. This is the Red Rose. You're not General Beatrix. Who are you? My name is Mikoto. Everyone is alive. You are very close to them. What? How do you know? I can hear him. Ooh. Just go. Don't ask questions. Prepare to land immediately. That's the Hildegard 3. Looks like Cid came to rescue us. Cid! Thank heavens you're all safe. Come quickly, we don't have much time.
We never do. Everything's quickly. I'm always so rushed.
Farewell, Zidane. Oh, damn it.
Voices in my head again.
What's wrong? Why don't you go on ahead? I'll catch up with you all later. I have to take care of something. What? He's still alive. He can't be. Zidane, what are you doing? Steiner, take care of Dagger. What? What do you mean by that? Kuja's still alive. I can't just leave him. This is ludicrous! Just because you two are from the same planet doesn't mean... No, that's not the reason.
Come on, Zidane. Why are you doing this?
Because I might have done the same thing if I were in his shoes. I probably would have fought against you guys and wreaked havoc in Gaia like he did. I know it sounds crazy, but I know deep down inside I have to do this.
You're not crazy, Zidane. But you go help Kuja, not good idea. It's too dangerous.
I can't just leave him. There's no way I could live with myself. I'm going.
You're making a big mistake.
Maybe. But we all have to make big decisions in life sometimes. For me, now's that time. I have to face up to it just like Vivi did when he confronted his fears to find out about himself. That was a big decision for Vivi.
I don't know about that. I don't think it was really a big deal.
That's what you think, but I might not be doing this if it weren't for you. You've definitely taught me to take life more seriously.
Well, you're obviously not going to change your mind, so I'm coming with you.
The principle of knighthood requires that one assist his comrade in times of need. I shall accompany you as well.
Whoa, wait a minute. Like I said, it's my moment, so don't butt in. You guys will have your own someday. Besides, you guys have more important things to worry about, like Bermesia and Alexandria.
For once in your life, why can't you be honest?
Sorry, but I can't...
I can't just walk away. It goes against my nature.
Huh?
You're a real simpleton.
Sid's like, I thought I told you to hurry.
Forget it, guys. There's no stopping this fool.
What are you still doing out here? Get on board right now!
That's what I'm saying. Come on, let's just leave him and get out of here. That guy will never change.
Alright, you heard the man. Get out of here before it's too late.
Zidane, I love you. You'd better come back.
Oh my gosh, she runs away after that announcement.
Zidane, I need to eat more different food. I'm still hungry. You come back. Take me more places. Show me more food.
I still can't believe you're doing this. You've changed, Zidane. Till we meet again.
Zidane, you've taught me another big lesson in life. Thanks.
Zidane.
Princess, we must go.
Your Highness. The abduction is over. I can't take you any further. I'm sorry for being so selfish.
No, you're not being selfish. You've done so much for us. If it weren't for you, I probably would have led a meaningless life. With you, I was able to see so much of the world and meet so many people. We faced many hardships too, but I think I finally know what's important. I'm so fortunate to have met you. I'll never forget our trip together. Thank you, Zidane. Promise me one thing. Please come back.
Nope, no promises. You know me, I'm crazy. I like to screw things up. Ooh, cutscene. Oh, wow. They're really leaving me behind here. Really? I don't think I'll ever get... Though Amaranth calls him the simpleton, I don't know if I can ever understand Zidane.
Kuja, can you hear me? I'm coming to get you.
You still have time.
Forget about me and go. Just shut up and stay where you are. I don't understand you.
Okay, here goes nothing. Oh, man. Zidane, you're a fool. Whoa. Oh my gosh. This is why you don't skip cardio day, in case you ever need to outrun a hentai tree. Never skip cardio day. Are we seriously? Oh my gosh, looking at me so happy with himself right now. I'd be holding on for dear life. I wouldn't be standing there with a smug look on my face, that's for sure. There he is. Landed right in- oh wait, no, we didn't land. We're hovering? Oh, he's way up there. Am I gonna have to walk all the way back up there? Because if I am, I'm gonna be pissed. Whew. Still alive. I guess that was pretty crazy. Alright, it's running for me. I don't even have to push a button. Hey, are you alright? Zidane?
What are you doing here? I thought I told you to go.
Wouldn't you do the same for me if you knew I was dying?
No.
Never mind.
Your comrades were able to escape?
Yeah, I knew you had something to do with it.
I'm glad they made it.
Yeah, well, it's our turn to get moving.
I don't deserve to live after all that I've done. I'm useless to this world.
No one's useless. You helped us escape, remember? Of course, we wouldn't have been here in the first place if Kuja weren't here, just saying.
After you guys beat me, I had nothing left, nothing more to lose. Then I finally realized what it means to live. I guess I was too late.
Oh. Figured out how to live the last 10 minutes of your life.
Hey, don't you go dying on me, all right? Huh?
Uh-oh. You might want to skedaddle now, Zidane. Oh, jeez. Skedaddling is highly recommended. Moseying is also an option. I personally would have not done it in the first place, but, you know, whatever, I'm not about helping the enemy.
Kuja, what you did was wrong. But you gave us all one thing, hope. We were all created for the wrong reason. But you alone defied our fate. We do not want to forget this. We want your memory to live on forever. To remind us that we were not created for the wrong reason, that our life has meaning. Sometime later,
Thank you. Aw, little Vivi. Got a new ticket, or is this from before? No, it said sometime later.
So, this is Alexandria. Well, pick up the pace, will ya? I don't believe it! Vivi! Vivi? How do you know that name? What are you talking about? It's me, Puck. How could you forget me? Puck? You know, Puck. The Prince of Bermesia? Oh, come on. What's wrong with you? If you're not Vivi, then who are you? I'm Vivi's son.
Oh my gosh. Multiple Vivis.
Yeah,
look at all the Vivis! Oh my gosh! It's like they came off a conveyor belt. Little Vivi army.
I always talked about you, Zidane, how you were a very special person to us because you taught us all how important life is.
Freya, you're leaving soon, are you not?
Yes, I can hardly wait to see everyone.
Alexandria, I went there many years ago.
Aww, she's back with her love.
How long will it take to rebuild Bermesia?
I don't care, as long as I'm with you.
Aww,
I love you, Freya.
Yet he still doesn't remember our past. I just want to cherish our time right now.
Man, that sucks, though. Not remembering he never got his memory back.
You taught me that life doesn't last forever. That's why we have to help each other and live life to the fullest.
That's a good life quote right there. I wish we could stick that on a big, giant billboard in the sky.
It's time to say goodbye to this room.
Save the Queen. You have served me well. My duty is finished here. Farewell, Alexandria.
I guess there's no need for a army general if there's no wars.
Even if you say goodbye, you'll always be in our hearts. So I know we're not alone anymore.
Why are you going to Alexandria?
You're not going?
I never said that. Hey, wait! Why I was born, how I wanted to live. Thanks for giving me time to think.
Good food, not only delicious. Good food made with heart. This very important when cooking for friends.
To keep doing what you set your heart on, it's a very hard thing to do. We were all so courageous.
Hurry, hurry! We gotta get there before the play begins!
Did they adopt Aiko? There's no need to hurry. The theater ship is no match for my new ship. My new Hildegard is the fastest ship ever.
Do I have to remind you? You've said the same thing about the theater ship. Ahem! That's what you said, Father!
Aw, they did adopt Aiko.
Aiko, what did you just call me?
Aw, darling, she called you Father.
Father, Mother, hurry!
Say it again, Aiko. Aw.
What to do when I felt lonely? That was the only thing you couldn't teach me. But we need to figure out the answer for ourselves.
Thank you. Beatrix! Where are you going?
Please don't ask. My mind is already set.
Wait! Listen to me!
Thump, 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 thump.
I never wish to lose you again!
Steiner.
Let us protect the Queen together!
Aww. I'm so happy I met everyone. I wish we could have gone on more adventures, but I guess we all have to say goodbye someday.
All right, you scumbags, we're almost there. Been a long time since we saw Alexandria. Let's give them a show they won't forget.
Yeehaw! Break a leg, people!
Everyone, thank you. Farewell. My memories will be part of the sky.
Man, did Zidane really, off himself? I just kind of imagined he got out somehow. You know how these Final Fantasy games are. I'm waiting till the game actually ends.
The theater ship will arrive any minute. It's been so long.
Her hair's grown back.
I can't wait to see everyone. But it'll never be the same. I have to let go of the past. I have to move on, just like he taught me.
I feel like Zidane's gonna come rolling out here at the end. They wouldn't really kill him off, would they? I'm waiting, though.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight's performance is a story that takes place long, long ago. Our heroine, Princess Cornelia, is torn from her lover, Marcus. She attempts to flee the castle, only to be captured by her father, King Leo. Tonight's story begins when Marcus and Cornelia decide to run away together. And now, your Royal Majesty, Queen Garnet, Lord Steiner, Lady Beatrix, noble ladies and lords, and our rooftop viewers, Tantalus proudly presents I Want to Be Your Canary.
Marcus?
Sweet Marcus, I fear I
love you. Princess, would thou be happy married to a lowly peasant such as I? Prithee, call me princess no more.
Marcus, wilt thou truly cherish me, the king's only daughter? Or is such a desire too dear to wish for? After our nuptials, shall I become no more than a puppet? A mindless puppet, never to laugh, never to cry. I wish to live my life under the sky. At times I shall laugh, at other times I shall cry. For no life is more insincere than that lived as a masquerade.
So much consideration thou hast given it, but worry not. Cast away thy trappings of royalty, and I shall swaddle thee in a gown of pure love. Never again will I part from thee.
Pray, my love, make me thy canary to keep forever in a cage of thy bosom.
Let us embark on the first ship tomorrow before dawn can...
All of my fortunes at thy foot I lay, and I shall fly.
I can't read it fast enough. No cloud, no squall shall hinder us. Can I, pause it? I didn't even try. The dialogue auto-scrolls at this point.
Oh, love is the sweetest joy and the wildest woe. All I wish is to be by my sweet Marcus's side.
I don't have it. Yeah, you can't pause it either, so.
Fie, it shall be war again unless the marriage is stopped. Ne'er will I let their plan come to fruition.
Good day to ye, Highness.
Good day.
Wist thee of Marcus?
Marcus, what news dost thou bring?
This.
The time for our departure is long past.
Where is Cornelia?
Marcus, the ship soon embarks. Board ye this boat alone, and peace could come to both kingdoms, as Blank so said. Speak, Marcus.
She told me that she could not live without me.
So the sun is our enemy too, the eastern sky grows bright. Will we not spread our wings as yonder birds in joyous flight? Hark, Marcus, they cannot wait any longer. The ship departs. Could she have betrayed me? Nay, nearer would my love speak false. I must have faith. She shall appear if I only believe. As the sun lends me no ear, I pray instead to the twin moons. I beseech thee, wondrous moonlight, grant me my only wish.
Aha! Bring me my beloved dagger to me. I knew that was going to be Zidane, but man, that's cruel. Making the chick her hair had enough time to grow that far, that long, from as short as it was. That took 6-7 years. He's been gone a while. Oh, they're not going to let her out? Aw, Steiner's being a bro for once.
Aw.
Beatrix says go for it. Aw, this is so cute. Oh, I love this. Oh my gosh, the queen's walking amongst all the nobles and common folk alike to get over to this stage. I mean, not every day people can say that they've been knocked out of the way by the queen, right? Like, she could have probably asked her guard to move everyone out of the way and cut a path through, but... oh no, her necklace! No! Oh no, the queen's necklace. She don't got time for that. Aww. Aww, that is so sweet. But it's kind of, I'm not gonna lie, it's kind of a dick move on Zidane to make her wait so long. Yeah, she punched him, he deserves it. Let him have it, girl. Man, I wouldn't have waited around for your butt that long, Zidane. I'd have moved on, you treat me like that. That's a good, I mean, Vivi had enough time to make like 7 more Vivis. A lot of time has passed. This is a lot of time.
Aw, even Steiner and Beatrix. Oh, that is so cute.
How did you survive?
I didn't have a choice. I had to live. I wanted to come home to you.
I just wanted to take my sweet time doing it, apparently.
So, I sang your song. Our song.
So Alexandria, yeah, enough time for Alexandria to be rebuilt completely even.
Alrighty guys, so that was Final Fantasy IX. Wonderful, wonderful game. My second playthrough of it, but like I said, you know, I didn't remember my first playthrough very well. So, you know, it's really wonderful playing through it again. I bet you I'm not going to forget it this time. And, you know, the fact that I just recently played so many other Final Fantasy games, I can definitely see, like, the similarities between this and other Final Fantasy games. So, for people that have played the older ones, like 3, 4, probably 5, I don't know, 6, this is definitely, you know,
something I think I can appreciate more, having played the other games. But, you know, the first time I played it, I had played 7, then 8, and then 9. And it's like, 9 was like, what's all these weird-looking people? And, you know, it's like, I couldn't appreciate it as much. And now I appreciate it a lot more. It's got a good story. I really like the story. It's got some really great characters. You know, I love that you've got a little black mage, Vivi. You know, that they kind of... they're more like, I don't know, they feel more like the original Final Fantasy classes and look more the role. I mean, even Garnet in her orange jumper, you know, prison suit jumper, like you see right there, she donned a white mage hood for a little while, right? So I like that they kind of made it more... had some nods to the older Final Fantasies and stuff, something that 7 and 8 didn't do, right? 7 and 8 went for the more sci-fi, futuristic thing, and I'm not trying to put those games down or anything, because they're okay, I love 7. 8, it's different. But 9, I didn't care much for, but it's because I didn't understand it. I played it when I was younger, and there's a lot of things I just didn't get, I think, and now I can understand it and appreciate it more, and I still think there's quite a few things I probably didn't fully understand in this game, but definitely appreciate it a lot more than my first original playthrough. And my gosh, this is the longest series of, like, a game that actually ends that I've made. I mean, I've got, a longer series as of now, but it's an online game, so it never ends, so that doesn't count. But this has been a really, really long game. I didn't remember it being quite so long, but, you know, I did do a lot of I did actually spend the time doing side stuff, so that's why it felt pretty long. I think that's probably my biggest, like, my only real gripes about this game were, you know, some of the side stuff did feel extremely tedious, you know, having to be pixel perfect where you do the chocobo dig and stuff, and extremely, extremely time consuming, and I did it with, you know, on the PC with the speed boost, and it was still very tedious. So anyone that's done like 100% completion on like PlayStation 1, it's like, ooh, you had to invest some time and some dedication into that, and that's not something I think I could ever do, to be perfectly honest. That's a lot. There's a lot to do in this game if you want to 100% clear it. In fact, as far as speedruns go, I'd be kind of curious to see what the 100% clear, like, fastest run of Final Fantasy IX is, but... I don't know, there's just so much to it and so many extra side things, right? But yeah, this has been a really, really wonderful game. I definitely, like I said, appreciate it a lot more than I did when I was younger. It's definitely not a bad game. Not at all. Not bad at all. Beautiful music, as you can hear. Beautiful graphics, especially for the time. I think the graphics were quite lovely for the time. When I was younger, the graphics kind of bugged me because it seemed like Garnet had like a really huge head, and maybe that's still the case. The characters seem like kind of big-headed, but, you know, after playing like a, you know, after when you kind of get into the whole world of it, really get into the whole fantasy of it, you know, it's okay for them to be like kind of weird looking, that's the point, you know. But like I said, the first time I played it, I just played 7 and 8, which was trying to go for the super serious, realistic, no hippo people kind of thing, right? Not that 7 was super realistic with their little block hands and stuff, you know, on the field, but you guys know what I mean. But, yeah, you know, this one, I think, is a good one. I think it's one of those ones, though, it's wonderful just like it is. Like, you know, I can't imagine it needing, like, a full remake. Like, a full remake of, like, 4, 6, and 7. Well, 7's coming out. But a full remake of, like, 4 and 6, I think, would be really cool. But this one, I don't know, it's so charming just the way it is. Like, the only way to make it better is, like, having it on the PC version where you can, you know, use the little speed-up boosts so you can do some of the more tedious things like chocobo hot and cold a little bit faster. And, You know, like I said, the only other real gripe is, like, the combat. You know, even with the combat speed feels kind of slow, kind of weird. And, you know, I mean, I don't know these kind of games usually are, but for whatever reason in this game, it feels extremely sluggish, and even loading in takes a while, right? So, combat leaves a little to be desired, but more for technical, I think, reasons more than the actual combat. Like, I kind of like that you can mix and match your abilities to suit a different situation, but the thing is, you don't really know what abilities are going to be good for your situation unless you either look up a guide or you've played through it before and it's like, oh, I know this guy's going to confuse me, let me equip clear-headed, right? Oh, there's both the planets combining here. I love this tune. It's beautiful. That's so pretty. I love this game. This is a good one. This is really a good one. One of the last, like, really good Final Fantasy games until they started getting kind of weird, right? So, that was Final Fantasy IX, guys. Thank you so much for watching me play Final Fantasy IX. I really do appreciate each and every one of you. I know this was definitely a long one, so thanks for sticking around. And I'm going to be playing more Final Fantasy games on my channel, so if you're not subscribed already, maybe you should, and you can see all my other wonderful series. And if you have time to leave a like, I would appreciate that too. If you want to leave a comment, let me know what you think of the ending here, some thoughts, insights to the game that I might not have thought about, things I might not have connected in my brain. I'd really love to hear from you guys. Anyways, thanks again for watching, and bye for now.